Hello everyone. This is a supermarket haul of makeup from my supermarket, which is Shores. Some stuff slid away, so yeah, they had a bunch of different makeup for a dollar. Partly because they're not going to be carrying these particular items, or the items stopped being made. You know how you find something and then they stop making it? Well, yeah. So I picked up a lot of stuff. I went 2 days in a row. It was 2 bins the first day. I went back the next day and there was only 1 bin and it was mostly nail polish. But let's jump into it. The first up is the L'Oreal Paris Voluminous Extra Volume Collagen Mascara in black. There we go. $1. Is it waterproof? I don't know. Doesn't say. Oh, yes it does. Waterproof. I picked up the L'Oreal Voluminous Miss Manga Rock in Blackest Black. This is also waterproof. Looks like this. I'm a sucker for the packaging. Everything in this video will be a dollar. Next up is Maybelline Lash Sensational. This is in Blackest Black. This is not waterproof. Here we go. Alright, I'm just trying to grab everything that's in packages. Next up is Black Radiance Perfecting Eyeshadow Primer. Now, I actually just tried the Milani Eye Primer. I know I'm late to the game, but I was stuck on Tarte's 12-hour one and they stopped making it, so I was like, well, let's try Milani, and I really love that one, so I'm wondering if this will be good for me. I don't know if I'll keep it or give it to a friend. Might just keep it as a backup. Next up is Almay Clear Complexion Light Medium 4-in-1 Blemish Eraser. It's coming up darker on screen than what it is. It looks like it'll work on my skin. If not, I'm only out $1, so it's not too bad. I'm trying to get all the skin stuff together. Next up is CoverGirl and Olay Simply Ageless 3-in-1 Liquid Foundation in number 220 Creamy Natural. And that's this. And it looks super light and I almost didn't get it, but it is actually my color right now because I am pale. Not quite as pale as I look in the screen, but it is what it is. I picked up Physicians Formula Mineral Wear Talc Free Face Powder in Translucent Light. Looks like this. You pop it open, and then underneath is a little mirror and one of these brushes. I don't think I'll use them to actually put stuff on my face, but I'll use those brushes for something. I just don't know what yet. Next up is another Physician's Formula, and this is the Summer Eclipse Radiant Bronzing Powder in Sunlight. It's shimmery, but it's light enough that it should work for me because I've purchased bronzers in the past, and they just look ridiculously dark on me. Next up is another Physician's Formula, and this is the Blush Happy Booster in Natural. And that's what it looks like. I like that it's pretty, just very, like, light. I don't like heavy blush. I only started wearing blush again, last year, so. Face product, I got a couple eyeshadows, is CoverGirl's True Blend Mineral Loose Powder in Light. And that's what that is. It's just a little loose powder. It was still, actually, the whole package was sealed when I bought it. Because I know some people, one woman was like, check the expiration date. And unless you have sensitive skin, usually it doesn't really matter, but moving on. I got three little eyeshadow palettes. Well, two palettes in a trio. The first up is Sweet as Candy. This one is by Wet n Wild, and that's what it looks like. It reminds me of Neapolitan ice cream. Is it the most pigmented? Not really, but I like to play around with it for a dollar. Now I picked up this Wet n Wild 8 shadow little thing because several YouTubers I follow said really good things about it. And that's the Wet n Wild Comfort Zone. Nice, neutrally colors. But oh lord. This one right here. Look, when I swatched it, it went on orange, but you see the blue? So yeah. I just love the way that one goes. I'm really, overall, shadow texture, I'm pretty impressed with. It's not the best, it's not the worst, but it's pretty smooth. Pigmentation's pretty good. Next up, I picked up, this is Downtown Browns by Black Radiance. And that's what this looks like. Now, I'm going to tell you right now, this side I'm way more impressed with just from swatches than this side. This one's a little patchy, but this and this one are actually really good. But like I said, some things can swatch beautiful on your eyes, look horrible. Swatch horrible, put it on your eyes, looks wonderful. I picked up one lip product, and it's a lip liner. Lip Perfection by CoverGirl in 225 Beloved. And it's this little pinky mauve-y color. And nail polish time. I'm just going to get through these real quick. I picked up Sally Hansen's gel polish in Pinky Promise. It's a nice little ballet slipper pink almost. You don't need a gel, one of those gel curing lamps for that one. This one is Wine Knot. It's also Sally Hansen, but this is not a gel one, it's just a regular one. Nice, pretty dark red. You can never have too many of these. It's the easiest way to kind of have a fancy manicure without actually doing too much. Next up is Revlon's Diamond Texture. And that's this one. There you go, you can see the shimmer. I don't know how sheer this is, so it may just be a top coat over a color. Because I have a silver opaque one that would look nice under this. I picked up, this one's called Extravagant. I love this pink purple color. It's coming off a little more purple on camera, but can't wait to paint my nails that color. Then I picked this up. It is also Revlon Liquid. Sorry, the price tag's covering the name. Liquid Quick Dry. You're supposed to be able to paint this on your nail, and it will dry your nails pretty much instantly. I haven't had anything like this since I ran out of the OPI Nail Dry. And that's everything, so until next time.